Hi everyone, it's Kathy Zilski. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I've got a couple card projects to share with you, and they feature a brand new set that I designed called Parental Props. I wanted to create a set that was all-purpose, not just for Mother's Day or Father's Day, but just for something to say to your parents, hey, I'm pretty grateful for you. All right, let's jump in and look at the products. The set is called Parental Props. And I just wanted a set of thin lined, that really minimal font, just with some mix and match types of things that you can use just to create a general card of thanks and gratitude. I hope you know how much I love and appreciate you. Stuff like that. I also have this little pattern, both in outline and circle, that you can use to create your own pattern if you're crafty and creative, but I'm not doing that. I will be using some Zig Clean Color markers to do some watercoloring. I've got some Gina K Designs embossing ink. This is new and I'm testing this out today. So far, so good. Got a little bit of embossing powder and I'm gonna be using a die to cut out the sentiment that I'm using today actually for both card samples. This set does have coordinating dies. I just don't have them in my house right now. I will be using the card swatch ring because I'm not sure what color of cardstock I'm going to use, but I am going to be using some of the Strathmore Bristol Smooth to do my painting on, and of course the Misty. So the first thing I'm going to do is just trace out roughly the size of this die, because I will be using this die, as I said, to cut out my sentiment. And I just want to make sure that I give myself a frame, because I don't need to do a full wash of color. All I'm going to do is create a watercolor frame that's going to stick out from behind the stamped and die-cut sentiment panel. So I'm taping it down with some purple tape, and I'm just gonna be doing the old scribble. Now, I just shared a video recently, and I'll link that above, where I basically rediscovered my Zig markers, thanks to Christina Werner. Thank you, Christina, for the inspiration. But now I feel like I can't get enough of them because they're a really great medium to work with. So all I'm going to do is take my brush and go around in rainbow order. Now, I realized as I was filming this and trying to angle, I don't really hold my hand at this awkward angle, but I didn't want to go too far out of my boundary because I want to preserve some of the edge around this as well, because I am going to die cut the whole piece once it's done. So again, working my way around in rainbow order, just a very messy watercolor frame, and coming over and just picking up the color. And actually, I loved what happened right there where it kind of blended and looked orange between the purple and the yellow. But I'm just coming back in and pumping up a little bit of the color where I felt like it needed a little more of a bump. Now, I'll just heat this a little and help it dry. And you can also just walk away. But I decided that I wanted to have a little more dedicated orange, so I just brought in another marker and used that to add a bit of orange up there at the top. And I'll have all these markers listed below if you're interested in what colors I used. All right, a little bit more there. Pick it up and drop it in. That looked a little better. Now I'm going to take my Distress Sprayer, just put a little water in my hand and flick it on. You can flick on any way you like. I'm trying this because I've seen other people do it, and it's so refreshing to put it on your hand. Thank you. Gonna blot it off with a paper towel, give that a little press, and when I lift it up, it reacts with the color below. I added a few more flicks because I felt like it wasn't quite flicky enough, and now it's flicky enough. All right. Now I'm bringing in the cardstock swatch because I just wasn't sure. I think lime green would have been great with this, okay? Love that key lime color from Gina K. But I decided that one of my favorite grays is Fog from Simon Says Stamp. It's a really neutral, warm, minimal gray, and I thought that's gonna be right for this card. So I used the die to place the stamp just so that I make sure I have the right amount of clearance. And today I'm using the new Gina K Designs embossing and watermark ink. And I just wanted to give it a try because I love Gina's dye inks and her amalgam ink. And I figured, well, I bet she's making a good watermark ink. Surely enough, I really like this ink. It gave a beautiful impression. I only stamped once. I was going to do it twice, but it's a very fine sentiment and I didn't want to muck it up. But once I poured my powder on and tapped it off, it looked really good. Like, it made a great impression. One thing I forgot to do though, I didn't use my embossing magic on this, and so I did have to go in and just kind of brush off some of that extra powder where the powder should not be. I got my heat tool nice and hot and then just went over this quickly until the embossing powder was smooth and melted. And I really like this. The gray is a very minimal light gray, but I think that has a really cool effect. Now, I'm going to take that die, tape it down, make sure it's all nice and square, and go ahead and cut out that sentiment panel. Just like that. And this is a Spellbinders Platinum 6 die cut machine. I really love this machine. If I could just get this off. Sometimes with purple tape, you have to be a little careful if you run it through your die cut machine, because it can stick, all right? Now I'm going to cut out this watercolor piece. I laid down the panel just to make sure it was centered and I was happy with the cut. And again, ran this through. The dies that I'm using to cut out these panels are from Waffle Flower Crafts. They're these A2 layers dies, and I've been using them a ton lately in card projects. Now this might not be the sexiest process, but this is how I measure my tape. You know, it's like all of a sudden the tape shows up, but you know, people have different approaches. And my approach is to just sort of line it up and measure it alongside the piece, and then just slap it on. The nice thing about this foam tape too is when you have a little bit of warp to your paper, and I only really recently connected to this, that foam tape, if you cover everything, it's gonna help that. You know what I'm saying? All right, this part I wanted to show as well because I do stamp inside my cards, but I don't always show it. And the nice thing about the Misti is you can stamp with the piece of cardstock hanging outside of the Misti. It's no big deal. It's not going to bend your paper. So you can score it. You can take your ink, and I'm hitting this twice. Another reason why I love this stamp positioner is that it gave me a really great impression for that sentiment for the inside of my card. I'll take the backers off all of the foam tape, and then I'm going to line that up, press it right down on that card base. I love that fog. Again, it just creates a really lovely, soft, clean and simple look. I just brought in my T-square at the end to make sure this was lined up and even. Now, I could have left it. I think this looks really great. I'm going to give this to my dad for Father's Day, but I thought, you know what? I'm going to add a little shine. There is no law that says 85-year-old dads do not love a little shine. And I think my dad, you know what? I think he's a shiny kind of guy. So, Dad, I hope you like the sequins. If not, Mother can enjoy them as well. So, that is the finished card project. This watercolor frame technique is just so simple, and you can do this in a variety of ways. The other card that I made, which I didn't show on camera, uses the exact same process. I just wanted to create something that was a little offset and use that key lime to stamp the sentiment. Thanks so much for watching today. I would love to have you become a subscriber, and I will see you back here with another card project soon.